morning, everybody. Welcome to Monday Morning Melodies. I'm Mike Baker, and I'm coming to you with this live stream from Goulburn, New South Wales, and in association with Hume Conservatorium. We like to think that we can help you get off to a good start for the week with a little dose of music. It's good for what ails you, isn't it? So for the next hour or so, I'm going to invite you to stay with me. I'm going to stay here behind the piano on this side of the camera, and I'm hoping that where you are, you can be plugged into a few of the good old tunes. I hope that you get a chance to maybe sing along or just listen, if that's what you're happy to do. Hum a bit, perhaps. Do a little bit of a shuffle around the kitchen. Monday morning's a good time to be doing a shuffle around the kitchen, isn't it? So I'm going to invite you, if you're tuned in on the Hume Conservatorium Facebook page, or you may even be on the Monday Morning Melodies Facebook page, I'm going to invite you to perhaps jump into the comments and just say hi. If you're new to us here, it'd be lovely to hear from you. None of this is compulsory. The only thing that's required is that you enjoy your time here with Monday Morning Melodies. So, as I said, I'm coming to you from Goulburn, New South Wales, and it's been a pretty wet old week here. But I looked out the window 5 minutes before we started off this morning, and I thought, oh, here's the sun. Isn't that fantastic? And now there's a bit more grey than there is blue out there, but we've had enough blue skies to give us hope for the week. And we've had enough blue skies to make me think Irving Berlin. Why does that make me think Irving Berlin? Well, I'm thinking Irving Berlin purely and simply because Irving Berlin wrote that beautiful tune, Blue Skies. I normally like to start off with something a bit up-tempo, and this might be a good place to start. I'll put some words in there with you, but I always like to say, I need all the help I can get. Hope you can help me along. Blue skies smiling at me. Nothing but blue skies do I see. Bluebirds singing a song. Nothing but bluebirds all day long. I never saw the sun shining so bright, never saw things going so right. Noticing the days hurrying by, when you're in love, my how they fly. Blue days, all of them gone. Nothing but blue skies from now on. Thank you. you're in love. My, how they fly, oh, blue days. All of them gone. Nothing but blue skies from now on. So do people still write songs about bluebirds? I sure hope so. That was Blue Skies by the very prolific Irving Berlin. Didn't he write a lot of great songs? Irving Berlin, of course, he was like a songwriting factory. He would just churn them out, and so many original melodies, from waltzes to quick steps to you name it. He just churned them out. Had a wonderful career. Okie doke. And I know... Actually, I know too from some behind-the-scenes stories that Irving inspired a lot of the Green-Eyed Monster. He inspired a lot of jealousy is probably not the right word for it, but a lot of his contemporaries were exasperated that he was so good at this songwriting business, and they found it very hard to compete. Let's have a little bit of a change of key here. This is a song that I quite like. It's by a guy called Ian Tyson. He's a Canadian. He wrote this song called Four Strong Winds. I hope you like this one. You might know it.
Thank you.
all those things that don't change, come what may. For the good times are all gone, and I'm bound for moving on. I'll look for you if I'm ever back this way. I'll look for you if I'm ever back this way. Almost sounds like it's unfinished, that song, but it needs to end there. If you learned a little bit of music, you might know that the chord that it ended on there was not the home chord. It ended on that wistful chord 5, we call it, as if to say something has gone unspoken. Particularly beautiful song, that one, Four Strong Winds. So, hope you're enjoying things out there. I'm not going to do too much talking today. I did a fair bit of talking last week by way of introducing myself and what this all is about. Well, in a word or in a sentence, it's just about putting some nice melodic music out there on a Monday morning. Anyway, let's have, while we're on the subject of blue, let's have a little bit of Richard Rodgers. Now, if anyone was going to give Irving Berlin a run for his money, you could make a case for Richard Rodgers. This is a tune of his. I just know you're going to know it. I started off with Blue Skies. What about a little bit of a blue moon? Standing alone, without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own. Blue moon, you knew what I was there for. You had me saying a prayer for someone I really care for. Suddenly appeared before me, the only one my heart could ever hold. I heard somebody whisper, please adore me, and when I looked, the moon had turned to gold. Oh, blue moon, now I'm no longer alone, without a dream in my heart, without a love of my. Richard Rodgers song, that one. The Rodgers and Hart song, actually. Lorenz Hart was his songwriting partner for that one. And actually, I'm going to have a stab here. I wasn't very far off with mid-30s. It's a 1934 tune, Blue Moon. And it's a very popular one from, you know, when you hear this, very familiar chord progression. I reckon a lot of the time you think, okay, we're in Blue Moon territory here. Fantastic. Now, going to take a little bit of a break from singing just to play you something that's a nice instrumental. Love is blue. Instrumental, that one from that was back in the 60s, the 1960s. It used to be we talked about the 60s as just being a couple of decades ago, or you know, think back now, the 60s, we're 50 plus years, aren't we, back into the 60s. But a lot of beautiful music, of course, came out of the 60s. And wasn't the 60s the era of songwriters too? I mean, Lennon and McCartney, we've got to put them up there. I might play some Lennon and McCartney for you. Last week, the sun started to get through my window here in Goulburn, in my little broadcasting studio here, and we found that George Harrison song, didn't we? Do you remember? That was, what's that one? Here Comes the Sun. We found that one to play. I'm going to see if I can find another Lennon McCartney song. Here Comes the Sun was George Harrison. And actually, we might even have another George Harrison song. That'd be an idea. So before we get off this morning, isn't it? Morning here in Goulburn it is. I know some of you people are in different time zones. I do another live stream on Friday afternoons, and a funny thing that has happened that you might appreciate, I have some listeners in the Northern Hemisphere who like to enjoy the Friday afternoon happy hour that we do, and they like to have their breakfast, while for us it's... We've just knocked off for work, a lot of people, 5 o'clock on a Friday, and it's time to put your feet up. And they're just getting started for the day. But two things have happened that have made that a little bit problematic for our friends, especially in England. And got a few friends in Sicily, too, that tune in quite regularly. They've gone out of daylight saving time at the same time that we've gone into it. And now what used to be 8 o'clock in the morning for them for breakfast is now, well, they need to get up and have breakfast at 6 o'clock if they're going to catch the Friday afternoon happy hour. But as I like to tell everybody, none of these broadcasts disappear. In fact, if there's some music that you like that you're hearing today, you don't have to be here to listen to it and then it's gone. So the Hume Conservatorium will keep it on their Hume Conservatorium Facebook page. It'll also be on the Monday Morning Melodies Facebook page. You don't even have to, you know, click the friends button or anything like on those pages. You just go back there and sort back through all the recent posts. You'll find the one from today, and you'll find last week's. And actually, last week was the first one we did in association with the Hume Conservatorium. Those of you who are Goulburn residents, I know I've got a few of them that like to tune in here, you'll notice that behind me, I've got the old tech building from, you know, the corner of Burke and Verner Street. That's now Hume Conservatorium. And Hume Conservatorium's a very big hive of activity for the music scene. Visiting artists come and play there, and there's a lot of students, and a lot of students that don't come into the Hume Conservatorium too. There's a lot of students who are out in schools, places like, you know, Dalton. How's that? Out past Gunning. That don't always find it easy to get into town here for music instruction. And Hume Conservatorium will send people out there to do the teaching. So it's a very agreeable situation. We've got a lot of students on the books down there. And always like to give the Hume Conservatorium a little bit of a plug before we have some more music, of course. Anyway, where were we last time? The reason I asked that is that I introduced you to a favourite book of mine last time. I'm going to show you again. Not everybody was here last time. If I can hold this up without it shining on the cover. Now, there's an old-fashioned sort of a book. You remember the old writing pads that you used to get that always had a beautiful face, a woman's face usually on the cover. You'd turn over the front cover of the writing pad, and there'd be a sheet of blotting paper. You don't see those around much anymore, do you? Because no one's using blotting paper. But this book is published by the Australian publishing company called Alberts, who have been very successful, especially when they sort of handed over their operations to Ted Albert, and he picked up the Easy Beats and Vander and Young, and then even AC/DC and all those hugely successful fellow that sang Love Is in the Air, John Paul Young, that's right. So anyway, this is a book that predates. I'm going to try to hold that correctly so it's, you can see it without the shine on it. And this used to be my Bible, as I like to tell people. I do a fair bit of work in playing piano in restaurants for people when they're eating. This was always my go-to book if I needed to find a song that was popular up until, this one goes up to the 60s. But there's nothing much more contemporary than that in here. I've got other books for that. But the original version that I used to have in this was in 10 separate little volumes. Each had 100 songs in them, and they were alphabetical. Anyway, at some stage, I won't say recently, but at some stage a while ago, Alberts put all of them together in one book. And a friend of mine very graciously gave that to me as a present, knowing how much I love these Alberts compilations. We started to turn the pages alphabetically, and last week I remember we got up to there's Barney Google with the goo goo googly eyes. There's Basin Street Blues, we had that one last week. Beer Barrel Polka went through to the Keeper because that was a little bit higher for this fairly limited voice that I've got. But I think we're up to nearly the C's. Right, so there's Blue Moon that we just had. And I'm looking through the Bees, The Boy Next Door, The Boulevard of Broken Dreams, The Breeze and I, Broadway Melody, and we're getting very close to being up into the seas, but here's one I'm going to hazard a guess that pretty much all of us know this one. So I'm going to play it, I think, in a different key to where it is, just to keep it in my singing range and maybe your singing range too. If you're singing along this morning, you might have a higher voice than me, but I'm going to keep it down here anyway. Classics of all time. Maud Dixon and Ray Henderson wrote that one in 1926. Bye Bye Blackbird. That has been sung around a lot of open fires over a lot of glasses of port over the years, I imagine, that song. That's a great sing-along. But when everybody's feeling just a little bit, shall I say, mellow, we're into the seas in our trawl through the Albert's 1001 book, and I'm a bit anxious to get to one of these next ones here. Now, there's one in French that I quite like. I'm not sure. I might work that one up for next week. I'll come back to that one. Give you a little bit of a thumbs up on that one. It's called C'est si bon. C'est si bon. It's so good is how it translates. c'est bon. Lovers say that in France. And a lot of these tunes take me back to the days. You remember when restaurants used to do wine, dine and dance? You'd go out to a restaurant, quite often an Italian restaurant. I had a favourite one called Indelicato's. My son Danny is one of his favourite restaurants too. And anyway, where was I with that one? Oh, the wine dance. You know, a little table for two in the corner, and you'd have a candle in a bottle, and your red wine might be a Chianti, you know, came in the cane basket. There might be a little trio in the corner playing some bossa novas. You could get up and you could dance in the restaurant. I used to play at a little restaurant that had a dance floor in the middle. Just took up about two table spaces. And when there was no music on, they'd bring out that missing bit of carpet and they'd put it over where the dance floor was, and they'd set a couple of tables up there. So anyway, one night I'm playing away and the restaurant was pretty dark. It was pretty quiet that night in the restaurant. And I'd finish the song and I'd hear... And I'd look out into the dark and I'd... Hello, oh, good, thank you very much, thank you. And couldn't really see anyone because it was a little bit, you know... The old wine, dine and dance scene used to be pretty, candlelit. It was a candlelit affair. Anyways, I play the next one and I finish. Thank you, everybody, thank you out there. And I'm still looking. It took me three or four songs to work out that out in the kitchen, they were tenderizing the steak. I felt about that big. All right. Here's some, let's get things moving a little bit. That's a boogie shuffle. Here's a tune that uses a boogie shuffle. Boogie Woogie, by the way, is train music. It started life on the railway work gangs. Back then they didn't have radio even. Certainly no TV, no electricity. And the railroad companies used to have a recreation hall, you know, where, the dinner hall where their workers would go because they'd be working too far away from home. And they'd have to stay out where they were working, out in the, you know, at the back of some mountain pass or, you know, miles and miles away from civilization. And so for recreation, the railroad companies would put a piano in there. They'd ship a piano out and they'd stick it in. And that was all the recreation that they had at the end of the day. So not a lot of the people could play the piano, but they knew the rhythm of a train. And so train music is where Boogie Woogie started. In fact, Boogie Woogie often ends with the train coming into the station and letting the air out of the brakes. Okay, here's a train song. Using a boogie bass. A straight shuffle. Pardon me, boy, is at the Chattanooga choo-choo. Track 29. Boy, can you give me a shine? I can't afford to board a Chattanooga choo-choo. My fare and just a trifle to spare. You leave the Pennsylvania station about a quarter to four. Read a magazine and then you're in Baltimore. Dinner in the diner, nothing could be finer than to have your ham and eggs in Carolina. When you hear the whistle blowing 8 to the bar, then you know the Tennessee is not very far. Shovel all the coal in, gotta keep it rolling. Woo-hoo, Chattanooga, there you are. Here's the train again. There's gonna be a certain party at the station. Satin and lace, I used to call funny face. She's gonna cry until I tell her that I'll never roam. Thank you. satin and lace. I used to call funny face. She's gonna cry until I tell her that I'll never roam. Now Chattanooga choo-choo, won't you choo-choo me home? And then the train comes into the station, lets the air out of the brakes. Train music. That had a straight shuffle feel to it. And did you hear in the middle section, or the bridge we call it, it went into a swing shuffle. Which is very different to... Different feel, isn't it? You've got the two boogie feels in the one song there. Two for the price of one. Chattanooga. What a name for a place. Isn't that just a wonderful name? Chattanooga, someone might tell me if I'm wrong, I believe it may be Chattanooga, Tennessee. Pretty sure it is, but please tell me if I'm wrong. That's Chattanooga Choo Choo. Goes back to 1941, that. Back to the era, of course, that was during World War II, wasn't it? 1941. And that era was the swing music was big. Well, jazz is what they called it. These days, jazz is a little bit of a... It's sort of more a listening music than a dancing music. Back in the day before World War II, jazz was about dancing and partying and really letting your hair down and all that fantastic, crazy freestyle dancing they used to do, the jitterbugging and all that kind of thing. So the big swing bands, you know, the Miller bands and the Dorsey bands and Andrew Sisters, yeah. That was all pretty much par for the course back then during the war. And I don't think that we've actually gone back to that now. Like I say, jazz is now, I love modern jazz and I love traditional jazz. They're just different beasts. You're probably getting sick of the sound of my voice, I think, a little bit. So I'm just going to leave our Albert's book there. We'll go back to our alphabetical trawl through the book next week. But I had a request today. I was with some friends playing some music last Thursday night at the Goulburn Club. We like to go in there about 7:30 on a Thursday night and play some traditional jazz and blues. I'm a bit of a traditional jazz and blues enthusiast. And we like to go in there, and they've got a beat-up old piano in there that sounds like, I guess, the pianos that everybody would have been playing on back in the 20s and 30s. And we've usually got a upright bass and a washboard and a clarinet sometimes, just whoever wanders in. Anyway, last week, for some reason, we got into Mexican music, and I thought, oh, maybe I can do a couple of Mexican tunes when we get together next week. So what I want to do is I want to play a tune for you, give my voice a rest, called Cinco de Mayo, and that's a Mexican tune by a guy called Chris Montez. And Cinco de Mayo in Mexican means the 5th of May. Cinco? 5? May. Mayo, Cinco de Mayo, the 5th of May. And that's a big national holiday. And the tune's called Cinco de Mayo, so I'm going to play that. There was a version of this by Herb Alpert. You remember Herb Alpert and the Tijuana Brass? He did a version of this tune, which was pretty cool. Pretty cool. And it starts something like this. Let's see if I can remember it. Cinco de Mayo. Thank you. Adebayo. Oh, there's another Latin, not Latin. There's another Mexican tune that everybody associates with Mexico because it's called the Mexican Hat Dance. See, that's how much I can remember of it. They say, olé! That one just popped into my head. Let's have a little bit of Cherry Pink and Apple Blossom White. Snuck that one in there, didn't I? Did you recognise that? Started off there with Cherry Pink and Apple Blossom White, followed by Never on a Sunday. Never on a Sunday. Okay, now, I'm not sure how we're going to go, but I like to put in something Australian each week. Now, I dug out this John Williamson tune. See if the key suits me. I might just take it steadily. You'll know the chorus. But like I say, I like to put in a nice Australian song each week because everybody knows the Australian classics. Last week we had a bit of fun with, well, wrong word to use. We enjoyed, I hope, singing and playing Botany Bay. It's not really what you call a fun song, but gee, it's enjoyable to sing, isn't it, with that chorus, singing to rely, who rely at it. Anyway, this week, a more contemporary Australian song by our John Williamson. Let's see if the key's good. I've been around the world a couple of times and maybe more. I've seen the sights, I've had delights on every foreign shore. But when my mates all ask me the place that I adore, I tell them right away. You know what this is? Give me a home among the gum trees, with lots of plum trees, a sheep or two, a kangaroo, clothesline out the back, veranda around the front, and an old rocking chair. You can see me in the kitchen, cooking up a roast, or Vegemite on toast, just you and me and a cup of tea. And later on we'll settle down and go out on the porch and watch the possums play. Hey, give me a home among the gum trees, with lots of plum trees, a sheep or two and a kangaroo, clothesline out the back, veranda out the front, and an old rocking chair. There's a Safeway's up the corner and a Willie's down the street, brand new place they've opened up where they regulate the heat. But I'd trade them all tomorrow for a little bush retreat where the kookaburras call. And this is where you put in your favourite kookaburra. Oh, I can't do kookaburras. Hope you do one there. Give me a home among the gum trees, with lots of plum trees, a sheep or two and a kangaroo, clothesline out the back, veranda out the front, and an old rocking chair. Some people like their houses with fences all around, and others live in mansions, and some beneath the ground. But me, I like the bush, you know, with rabbits running round, and pumpkin vine out the back. Help me now. Give me a home among the gum trees, with lots of plum trees, a sheep or two or a kangaroo, clothesline out the back, veranda out the front, and an old rocking chair. Our John Williamson, and one of his biggies, eh? Had a few good big hits, didn't he? He had that. Do you remember how big that song, Hey True Blue, Don't Say You're Leaving, or whatever it is? Yeah, that was a big hit, that True Blue. And a lot of advertising campaigns locked onto that song too, didn't they? Somehow he just knows how to connect with his fellow Australian, that John Williamson. That's a fine example too, that song, Home Among the Gum Trees. I hope it created some nice images for you of, you know, sitting on the back porch, checking out the gum trees and the wildlife, you know, the possums and the kookaburras. I'm going to have to apologise for not singing it the way that John Williamson sings it, because he usually sings, give me a home among the gum trees, with lots of plum trees. And he sings, a sheep or two, a kangaroo, a kangaroo. Funny how little things like that can just, you know, get their hook in. So that was our little token Australian song for the day. I've got time for about another two tunes, I think. I'm going to go a little bit more contemporary. I'm going to play an instrumental song by a guy that didn't write a lot of instrumental songs, but what a fantastically talented songwriter. We didn't really hear much of Elton John until right on the very tail end of the 1960s. And he had that great song, do you remember? I think I can remember. Song called Your Song. That was when Elton John came to our attention, and we thought, hello, this is someone with a bit of talent, and he didn't prove us wrong. Anyway, most of his songs he wrote with a fellow called Bernie Taupin, who wrote the lyrics for his songs. But this particular one hasn't got any lyrics. It's called Song for Guy. Before, haven't you? That's a little bit like Home Among the Gum Trees, we were talking about that John Williamson song that got used on the television all the time, didn't it? Every time there was something Australia Day or, you know, some awards ceremony, you'd hear John Williamson's True Blue. Well, that song called Song for Guy. You would hear that under a lot of, television, where they needed some music to put under some, someone doing a voiceover or something like that. That got used a lot. So I'm coming to the end of my time today. I wanted to end with an Elvis song today, but I think I'm going to leave that till next week. I've really been enjoying being with you here for this last hour or so. And what I like to do, it's no secret, but one of my favourite melodies, a gorgeous melody, is Errol Garner's 1952 hit, Misty. And we might just fade out to the strains of Misty, but it's almost become my theme song, this one. Anytime I'm out somewhere, I just... find that those chords let people know, oh, there's a piano player here. So I'm just going to play a little bit of that, and like I say, I'm going to see you next week. Hopefully I'm going to be here. I'm not going anywhere in a hurry. My Monday mornings now have taken this shape of starting with Monday Morning Melodies, and actually I like the way that starts the week off. Gets my week off to on the right keel, that's what I'm going to say. Gets my week off on the right keel. And I just feel that, you know, there's good stuff going on in the world if we can keep some of these beautiful old melodies alive. That's my mission statement. That's my mission statement. Keep all the beautiful old stuff alive. I don't mind having that attached to my name. So everybody, it's goodbye to you on behalf of Hume Conservatorium. And this is Mike Baker. I've been behind the keys for you, with you, for the last hour or so, and I look forward to seeing you next time. everybody.